Great moments are born from great opportunity. And that's what you have here tonight, boys. That's what you've earned here tonight. You were born to be hockey players. Every one of you. And you were meant to be here tonight. This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
Don't we always love to push it to a game seven? Welcome, one and all, to the famed Herb Brooks Arena alongside the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York, as we get set to close out game seven of seven games on the gold medal docket. This one, a Grenoble 12U division matchup between New Canaan Winter Club and the Red Bank Generals. My name's Glenn Burnett with a play-by-play and color commentary. So good to be here. So glad you'd have me here alongside Robin, the smooth operator, as we get a look in at some of the context coming into this game. Last night, we saw, was it last night or was it yesterday? We saw New Canaan take a 2-0 victory against Red Bank Generals. The Generals now looking to avenge that loss. As we open up first period action this year, the 2:15 p.m. puck drop, November 13, 2022. As we open up action, shot wide of the net. I'll give a shout out to folks from both sides of the fence here for helping out with the pronunciations on the names. We appreciate all of the help and the goodwill. As this is played out across neutral ice, no icing as that was deflected on the way down. Chased in by Douglas. Out to neutral ice from the left wing side. Dropped off at the top of the faceoff circle. Ronan Fry out on the ice for the Generals. Played in from the right wing side as this is eased away by McQuillan. McQuillan in net for the Generals. Now a little bit of housekeeping ahead of this penalty being whistled as McQuillan comes out of the net, adding an extra attacker on the delayed call here. And now a little keep away. Played off of the side of the net. Kicked out in front. Played off of the end boards. Centering pass. And finally, whistle dead as Hibbert touches it. So, the format here, unlike the round-robin games where we had no overtimes and no timeouts, in the gold medal game, you get overtime if it's necessary, and each team gets a single timeout. Something to remember as we progress through the game. Red Bank on the power play, skating 5-on-4. Here's New Canaan. And so Hibbert for body checking. And now Jones along the left wing boards. Trying to kill off the penalty. Good way to do it is get into the offensive zone. As the Generals coming in, shot down the slot, deflected away, in net for New Canaan. Pemberton once again. As this is played out across neutral ice. Early shifts here for both teams as they will scrape up this ice a little bit and get those legs warmed up. Played out towards the exit door as we go back to even strength, 5-on-5. You see Pozitek out on the ice for New Canaan. Out along the near side corner. That's Connor Ryan. Up against Kunkel as this comes out to neutral ice. chasing it down, Finn Ryan. We've got a couple of Ryans here, Connor and Finn. And I understand, as the Generals come up with the icebreaker. .314 into the first period, and Red Bank out in front, 1-0. And that looks like Kunkel coming off leading the charge. We'll keep an ear out for Packer to call that over the PA. And so Kunkel from Fry. And as we look down that Red Bank roster, if I'm not mistaken, we've got Irish twins, Connor and Finn Ryan. Correct me if I'm wrong, please.
They're 18 months apart.
18 months apart. Wow, that's a lot of labor right there. Am I wrong? A lot of labor? 18 months worth. Wow. As we get a neutral zone face-off with 7:41 remaining in the period, Red Bank leading 1-0. Sent up ahead by Collette. We got a penalty. Interference. And so New Canaan sending Ryan to the box. And Red Bank goes to the power play. In the face-off circle, Collette opposite Ryan, the Connor variety. Played down from the point. From behind the net. A little off the mark on the pass. 27 seconds remaining on the power play. Centering pass, trying to get something worked out in front. Finally out around towards the point. And Stanislaro sends it back down low. And picked up by New Canaan. Racing out is Ryan. Ryan into the corner. Played out in front, shot, ricochet out in front, backhander, and that is in. An equalizer. As Connor Ryan puts that one in, equalizing the score. With 6.5 to go in the first period. We are all squared up at 1 apiece. From the near side, across neutral ice. Jones picking up the assist on the Ryan goal. As we have icing, go ahead and skate it back to the other end of the ice. Play down towards the end wall, out towards the far side. Sweeping around to center ice. Tossed up ahead by Pozitek. And now a wrister. This is Jones once again down in the corner. Jones has help on the wing. Out towards the point, just off the mark, as Fish was rotating down the blue line. From right wing side. Laid out towards the point, back down low. Kunkel with a shot, deflected up into the glass. Out to the far side, Jones picks it up. Jones whips that one down, and that hits off the side of the cage. And what a chance to take on that one as McQuillan watched that one go by, figured that would be icing, and indeed it was. That's right. Look at that. Jones off camera right now is showing, hey, that can't get into the net when I'm sealing it off like this. A lot of folks gasp when they see something like that, but McQuillan says, no worries. I've got it handled over here. Sorry, McQuillan, not to put any words in your mouth, but I think that's what you were showing us. And now out towards the right wing side. Working around the back of the net. This is Vitali. And a little misunderstanding there. As Leslie thought he had someone over on the opposite point. Played out to neutral ice. A quick change out there as Ryan Fish comes out on the ice. And now the off winger from the low angle shot. And Pemberton with the stop. 4:19 remaining, first period action. All knotted up at one apiece. Glenn Burnett with the play-by-play and color commentary. You will find my profile online at LinkedIn. You know what LinkedIn is, don't you know what it is? I feel like I might be talking a different language as Pemberton covers up. No, I'm sure there are plenty of people. I know that there are plenty of people out here who have that professional social media. It looks like Jones had stepped off the ice down the tunnel for a minute, coming back. Perhaps sprucing up a little bit. As Brazier sends it into the offensive zone. Now some exchanges as we see Connor Ryan back out on the ice. Played out towards the far side corner. Picked up by Brazier. Sent out of the zone into neutral ice. Out to the far side. Pozitek from behind the net. Shot wide of the net as we see Leslie posting up at the point. Popped up and bouncing towards the left faceoff circle as we see Morgan Thompson out on the ice for New Canaan. And rushing right into the zone, almost making an attacking opportunity. Shot as that was absorbed to the chest of Leslie. I think that's Leslie. Oh, no, that's Vincent. 2:36 remaining, first period action. As we set up a neutral zone face-off, both teams with a puck in the net. Veering out towards the left wing side, that's Vitali. This comes out to Ronan Fry. Fry with a shot. And just getting a piece on the blocker. Here's Jones. Played up ahead to Vitali. As Douglas goes down to the boards. Douglas getting up to the feet and finding a puck right there. How convenient. Played towards the net as this is chased down by Finn Ryan. From the half wall, Vitaly. As this pops out to neutral ice. Play down towards the near side. And wow, winding up, his foot sends it up ahead towards neutral ice. Chaplinski sends it down to the end boards. Battling down low, Chaplinski shot, and Pemberton with the stop. Chaplinski showing some good stick handling out there. That's right, this is how we do it. 69 seconds remaining, first period action. Around to the near side. And now racing up ahead, this is Ryan Connor. Into the middle, goes to the backhand. Denied. McQuillan with the stop. Looking pretty good in net right now. As we see Fish coming off the ice. And heading back on, that's Vincent. Play down the ice to the end boards. As Pemberton comes out of the net. Pressure down at the end boards. Played around to the near side. Nice toe drag move, but well played by Vincent with a poke check. Knocks that one away. 15 seconds left in the period. New Canaan looking for the exit door. Centering pass, picked up by Jones. Jones slings it off the glass, and that'll make it out to neutral ice, and that should just about do it for the period. And so at the end of one, we're all knotted up at one apiece. As we point up at the big board. We'll take a quick break, step outside, check the dew point, rotate the tires. When we come back, we'll have baking tips with Martha. Oh, Martha! From the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York, you're watching Can-Am Hockey, the Grenoble 12U gold medal game. We'll be right back. That's right. Well, that's why we play the gold medal game, to separate them. Oh, look at this. A little mix up there on the goaltending services. Forgetting this is the period of the long change. We got to trade nets. And so we welcome you back to the second period, as Doc Emmerich calls it, the period of the long change. As the goaltenders trade nets, now putting them and the defensive zones they guard on the opposite end of the ice from their benches. And so defensive on-the-fly substitutions are very difficult during this period. The key takeaway here is get into the offensive zone regularly and try to sustain the forecheck without any whistles. If you can do that, you can fatigue your opponent, as it is difficult to get those on-the-fly defensive substitutions. This period usually benefits the team that spends long amounts of time in the forechecking zone. Early second period action. As we are all tied up at one apiece. And if we are going to keep them separated, we're going to have no tie. Just a reminder that if we need overtime, yes, indeed, we will take overtime. Oh, ever hear about the 10 overtime period game here some years ago? 10 overtimes. Ask Maddie. He'll tell you about it. Can you imagine? Played around the back wall to the near side. As this is picked up from the corner, out towards the point. As Koski out on the ice on the weak side, as this slips right past Koski. Sometimes you want to stagger the attack on the weak side where the middle slot person is just a step ahead and the person further on the weak side is just a step behind, just in case the pass makes it through the slot out towards the weak side. It won't be too far behind the winger. Played up on the right wing side. As Stanislaro sends it in and around the corner boards. As Brazier out on the ice. Slung around the corner boards. Out to Stanislaro. Stanislaro, long windup, sends it down into the slot. Shot on the backhand as Jones picks it up. Jones from the end boards. As Kunkel trying to get a piece of it. Here's Jones out across the red stripe. Jones squaring up, shot above the cage, rebounded off the glass, out in front. And this will go down indeed for icing. 8:58 remaining, second period action. 1-1. That's right. As Steven Tyler implores, puck this way. Played back into the general zone. From the right wing side, toe drag move, squaring up and slinging that one off the end boards. Played out to the far side is Connor Ryan, picking up some speed along the left wing wall, taking out the official. As we get a whistle. That will set us up at the center dot. As we see Pozitek with the puck, dropped off to Thompson. Thompson with a shot wide of the net. And now up on the right wing side. That's Gallagher. And we have a penalty upcoming. And that looks like Chaplinski going to the box. This will give New Canaan a 1 minute power play. Jones taking possession off the faceoff. A little mix up there as the puck deflected into neutral ice and now further making things worse as Vanham had an opportunity up front. Jones coming in just in time to hold his own. And so cross-checking for Chaplinski. Skating shorthanded into the offensive zone as this is covered up by Pemberton. 7:09 remaining, second period action. In this, our final gold medal game of another fine Can-Am hockey round robin weekend. This, our fourth consecutive weekend in a stretch of seven consecutive weekends. Played around to the near side. Working up ahead towards the offensive zone is New Canaan, having to tag back up. And now coming in with a shot on net, and Pemberton scooping that one up, holding it high and tight. 6:48 remaining, second period action. Can it be more evenly matched? I don't know. Ask me next period. Shot deflected out in front, and Pemberton. That's called getting low, folks. Getting real low. Setting up to Pemberton's right side. What's that? Puck you like a hurricane? As we are even strength, 5-on-5. This is Thompson sending it up into the offensive zone. Chaplinski out on the ice for the Generals as Jones comes away with it. Jones angling it up across neutral ice. Midway through regulation. 6 minutes left in the second period. Played around to Hibbert. Hibbert easing it up to Jones. Jones easing it up to the end boards. Played across the near side wall. As we get a tripping penalty. And it looks like Marowa going to the box for a minute. And now Red Bank going to the power play. Foot out there trying to snap the stick. Looking to cash in on the warranty. As this slips off of the blade to the backhand, and a shorthanded goal with 25 seconds left in the penalty kill. And a big play there for New Canaan as they step out for the lead. Who's that? Connor Ryan. No better way to kill a penalty than with a shorthanded goal. Still 25 seconds left on the power play.
The goal was unassisted. Tap the goal at 7:06, second period.
For those of you who are looking for the official scoring on this, go ahead and visit canamhockey.com. Click on the game info link and follow the pathing to your game, and that'll show the official scoring. That's everything that goes from the official to the scorekeeper's desk, from the scorekeeper's desk after the game up to Tournament Central and onto the database. As we go back to even strength, fired down the left wing side as that sweeps all the way around towards the far side half wall. Douglas wisely rotating over the top as his point mate pinches down. That's Dennis Lauro on the right side. Both listed as number 25 on the game sheet, but Douglas is 24, Dennis Lauro is 25. Here's Brazier. Laid down around the end boards. Quick changes for New Canaan. Now Red Bank trailing by one with 3.5 to go in the second. With a steal in the offensive zone. And persisting. This is Kunkel working the skates. Kunkel once again. And Red Bank continue to turn up the pressure. Played on the right wing side, centering pass, stolen away, and fired down the ice. That will go down for icing. And that'll buy a breather for everyone on the ice. As we see Pozatek out on the ice, along with Brazier, Thompson. We see Cooper Henu up at the point, number 10 for the Generals. From the left side, shot over the net. Generals working it out to neutral ice as we get a whistle. Can we get a look down at the sweater down on the glass there? That right there, I believe that might be Colin Palmer, the center for Paul Smith's Bobcats men's hockey. He's the cameraman on their basketball games. Nothing like a little cross training. Played around towards the far side half wall. As this comes towards the blue line, poked back in. 1:43 remaining in the second. New Canaan in green leading 2-1. Glenn Burnett with a play-by-play and color commentary. Find me on LinkedIn. This is Thompson sending it deep into the attacking zone. Out through the faceoff circle as this comes around to the near side. Behind the net. Centering pass out to the back door. Could not connect on that one as Fiore was out on the right side.
Go guys, go!
And so the Generals, wow, just testing the headgear. Generals send one to the box. That'll be Foot. Huh? Who, me? Look at that. I got at least got the attention on the ice there. And now New Canaan to the power play. This is Brazier behind the net. 28 seconds remaining in the period. As this is kicked out from the left wing side. Play down in front. Ryan with the shot, cleaning up on the backside. No goal as Pozitek arguing that it is a goal. Oh, yes, we have some Paul Smith's College Bobcats in the house. If you look down at the end of the locker room tunnel there alongside the glass, you'll see a couple of the Paul Smith's College Bobcats skaters, including one of the centermen, number 44, Colin Palmer, down by the ice there. Can you see him? Hey, Colin, give us a wave. There we go. See, that's Colin right there. Let the folks know who you are. That's Colin Palmer, Paul Smith's Bobcats centerman. Picked up a goal in a 6-5 win last week. Down along the glass there. They'll be playing at 3:45 p.m. And then the Paul Smith's College Bobcats women's ice hockey team will follow that at 6 p.m. Hockey all day, all night, huh? 11 games yesterday, folks. And we're picking up 9 of them today. Yeah. Oh, yeah. We'll take a quick break, step outside, rotate the tires. When we come back, Jonathan will teach you how to build a floating bookshelf. From the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York, you're watching Can-Am Hockey, the gold medal edition. We'll be right back. All right, folks, welcome back as we open up third period action. 16 seconds left on the New Canaan power play. New Canaan leading 2-1. Red Bank trying to draw even as this one comes up and out of play. Good catch, coach. Good catch, coach. That's right. That's what they call him. As we get a chance to acknowledge the coaching, Peter Herms. Well, Red Bank side, Jonathan Fiore, James Collette, and Greg Foote as the assistants. Head coach over on the New Canaan side, Christopher Bozio, Clark Jones, and Sean Ryan as the assistant coaches. Shout out to them. As we get back to even strength, 5-on-5. Played up ahead on the left wing side. Sent around towards the near side. Hibbert carrying it up along the left wing side. Chasing it down into the corner. Battling with Henu. Played up the ladder, out to neutral ice. Back out across to Jones. Jones. And we got what looks like a call-up coming here as we see McQuillan coming out of the net. And a hold that was caught behind the play. And so Red Bank will go to the power play for a minute, trailing by one as Jones goes to the box. Played from the half wall. Out across to the left wing side. As Barbudi out on the ice for Red Bank. Played away from the half wall. Shot. And Pemberton with a stop. Played out to the point. Down around to the corner. Needing a little bit of help there as Gallagher out on the ice for Red Bank. Wrister as that one comes bending down into the glove of Pemberton. As we've got a face-off to Pemberton's right. Oh, check this. John Lewis in net. That's John Lewis on the grab. And by the way, folks, if we had been calling Pemberton's name at any time when he was making plays in the net, or when Lewis was making plays in the net, all of that stuff officially is on the game sheet, game info link at canamhockey.com. So if I made the error of giving credit to any of the good play for Pemberton, when in fact it was Lewis there, all apologies. As this plays down to the far end. That'll go down for icing as we're back to even strength, 5-on-5 on the ice. 9:29 remaining, third period action in this, our final gold medal game. As this is sent down for icing, we'll be right back. As this is played along neutral ice, just in case. And that is Robin on the dance cam. Played out towards the left wing side. Red Bank down by one, just under 9 minutes remaining in regulation. New Canaan looking to gain an advantage, a little bit of insurance, and this might help out a little bit. As Red Bank sends one to the box. Jones on the faceoff, played back to the point, and denied by Douglas.
Red Bank generates by penalty number 33, Nicholas Fiore. He receives one minute to the trigger. Time of the penalty, 3:13, third period. Fiore for trigger, 3:13.
Connor Ryan racing into the offensive zone, losing an edge on the way in. New Canaan would love to pick up one more goal for insurance as Jones carries it in on the right wing side. 15 seconds left on the power play. Played out to neutral ice. This is Ronan Fry. Poke checked away. Shot. Fry trying to get the redirect down low. We're back to even strength. 5-on-5. And heading straight into service, Fiore. Fiore posting up on the weak side. Play down low, and Fiore, fresh out of the box, sends it out across the crease. Close call there. as Lewis trying to keep things clean. Fiore on the right wing side, shot, blocker down in front. As this is picked up by Morawa. From behind the net, Red Bank with a sense of urgency. 7 minutes remaining in regulation. As this is slung all the way down, that'll be icing. And so we'll go ahead and walk that back up to the other end. Played from below the goal. Getting a lot of pressure down low. That's Vincent. As Vincent posted up out in front of the crease. Coming down to the corner. Kunkel pressing in. As Kunkel battling with Ryan. Out into the middle. Shot on the short side. Lewis trying to track the puck. Lifted up as that comes off of the end boards. As that goes down to the end wall, it'll be icing again. Lots of changes out on the ice. As we see Jones and company heading down to Lewis, keeping him encouraged. From the right side, this is Thompson, centering pass, taken away by Chaplinski. Chaplinski working through the center stripe. Turn back around, holding out, needing to tag up as Kunkel comes up with it. Played out into the offensive zone as Red Bank needing one, shot, rebound. Protecting the puck with a shot. From the low faceoff circle, little toe drag move out in front. Lewis with the stop, and that is blown dead. 5:11 remaining in regulation. I think we'll do the ceremony on this. Played to the near side. Is that one squeezed by Lewis? Played out across towards the left side. From the near side corner. New Kanan carrying it out. This is Ryan. The Connor version. Played around to the near side. Vitaly working out towards the far side half wall. Keep a close eye on things now as we get down to the 4 minute mark. As we may see a net getting emptied. As that plays down for icing. So we'll go ahead and skate that up towards the other end. Go, played out across the dashers and into the general's box. And that'll set up a neutral zone faceoff on the near side dot. Picked up by Brazier. Koski up on the left wing side as this is picked up by Jones. Jones flips it out towards the right side. Pozitek helping with Jones. As we get a whistle, Jones lost the stick and just kept physical along the boards. As we got Thompson back out on the ice. There's Connor Ryan in the center position. Ryan, as this is swept away, 3:08 remaining. Swept out towards neutral ice as this will be gathered up by Vincent. From behind the net, Vincent slings it around to Brazier. Played out into the middle of the zone, sent down towards the corner. Still no movement in the general's net. 2.5 to go, centering pass. Played off of the glass as that one will go down the ice. No icing. Played out to neutral ice. Taken away from Jones. Kunkel from the right side. Shot for the far side post. And Lewis making the stop. Played out to the corner. Still no movement in the general's goal. Played by Stanislaro. Back up to neutral ice. Ronan Fry on the right side. Gaining the inside. Played out towards the corner. Still no movement. 99 seconds remaining in regulation. Racing back on defense. Tossed down to the end boards. That'll kill off a little bit more time. Quick change for New Canaan. As the energy starts to ramp up. Played into the middle of the zone. Here's Ryan. And now the generals have to get it up ahead into the offensive zone if they have any hopes of getting an extra attacker. Held up in the corner, finally dragged out by the Generals. 40 seconds remaining as a new Canaan skater goes down. The net is empty as Schaefer comes out of the net. 25 seconds as new Canaan trying to tie it up at the base of the boards. Shot deflected out in front, loose out in front. Lewis with a stop. No goal, as that had been whistled. With 16 seconds remaining. Right down to the wire, folks. And it is timeout time.
How much time is left?
'Cause they will whistle this pretty quickly. And then if it goes to 5 seconds left in the timeout,
If it goes to overtime, then we switch.
All the marbles, all the pucks, all the skaters, 6-on-5, 16 seconds left. Final gold medal game of the day. Played out from the half wall, shot out in front. Swept out towards the point. This one will slip out to neutral ice. Kunkel trying to fire it back into the offensive zone. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and that'll be it. We'll go ahead and take a quick break and come back for the handshake as we finish out our celebrations from the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York. You're watching Can-Am Hockey, the gold medal edition. We'll be right back. As both teams gather at the center stripe to exchange goodwill on the handshake line, oh, what a game. Good game, good game. Safe travels, good meals, and good luck. What a great day to be a hockey player. What a great day to play hockey. And at the end of regulation, holding out, defending their zone over and over, with a flurry of activity coming on from the Red Bank Generals. New Canaan fending off the attacks and taking the victory. We'll go ahead and take a quick break and step back for the awards ceremony from the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York. You're watching Can-Am Hockey, the gold medal edition. And we'll go ahead and cut it away ahead of the award ceremony. As we go ahead and award the silver medals.
Number 4, Brady Hibbert. number 20, Cody Jones. Number 30, Teddy Pemberton. And the coaching staff will be completing winner ball, head coach Christopher Mazzeo. Assistants Sean Mellon and Cody Jones. Your division finalist. Congratulations, Duncan Winterfall. At this time, we'd like to have both teams and three representatives come to our podium for a Cooper and Paul tournament with the Canadian Arena Bear, Jake Jinglack, and Olivia McCoy.
Have it, folks. Silver and gold, gold and silver atop the podium.
We wish both teams success on the rest of their seasons, and please travel home safely.
And there you go, New Jersey and Connecticut. And now a portrait of gold. Down and around the podium as New Canaan Winter Club grabbing up the victory, gaining the arena banner, the Challenge Cup plaque, the Olympic torch, the gold medals, and the smiles from coast to coast. What a great exhibition of hockey out here across the weekend. This, our fourth consecutive weekend of seven consecutive weekends of Can-Am hockey. All just as exciting and fun as the next. We hope you've all enjoyed your time here in the Olympic Village of Lake Placid. I know I have. Thank you all for all of the assistance on the names and all of the feedback. Really do appreciate it. We hope to see you back again. As we go ahead and clear things out and get ready for some Paul Smith's Bobcats college hockey. The men's playing first at 3:45 p.m. and then the women at 6 p.m. That'll be good times as well. For Matt Scheller, our producer, my camera operator, the smooth operator, Robin, and for Can-Am Hockey, my name's Glenn Burnett, shutting down this broadcast, closing it out for this weekend, another good one. From the 1980 rink in Lake Placid, New York, you've been watching Can-Am Hockey, the Gold Medal Sunday edition. We'll see you on the next one.